So first question, factorize x square plus 6x plus 8. Here the question is of the form ax square plus bx plus c. So to solve this particular problem, first multiply the coefficient of x square and the numerical value. So we get 8, and then down you write the coefficient of x term, that is 6. So write two numbers here such that when you multiply them you are supposed to get 8, and when you add them you are supposed to get 6. So the numbers are 4 and 2. So that is plus 2 and plus 4, because when you multiply you will get plus 8, and when you add them you will get plus 6. So in the next step, write x square. So now replace 6x by 4x and 2x. So we'll get plus 4x plus 2x plus 8. So in the next step, you can take x as common from the first two terms, and here you can take 2 as common. So when you take x out, you will get x plus 4 plus. So similarly, when you take 2 out, you will get x plus 4. So now group the terms, you will get x plus 4 into x plus 2. Second question, factorize x square plus 4x plus 3. So again, multiply the coefficient of x square and the numerical value, you will get 3. And when you add them, you are supposed to get 4 here. So the numbers are 3 and 1, that is plus 3 and plus 1, because when you multiply you will get plus 3, and when you add them you will get plus 4 as the answer. So now replace 4x by 3x and x. So we will get x square plus 3x plus x plus 3. So here you can take x as common. So take, so we will get x plus 3. Next you have x plus 3, you can take 1 as common. So plus 1, you will get again x plus 3. So when you group them, we'll get x plus 3 into x plus 1. Third question, factorize a square plus 5a plus 6. So when we multiply, we'll get 1 into 6, 6. And when you add, we're supposed to get 5. So the numbers are plus 3 and plus 2. So now replace 5a by 3a and 2a. We'll get a square plus 3a plus 2a plus 6. So here you can take a as common, so a into a plus 3. So similarly here again you can take 2 as common, so plus 2 into a plus 3. So when we group them, you can take a plus 3 out, so a plus 3 into a plus 2. Fourth question, factorize a square minus 5a plus 6. So multiply the coefficient of a square and the numerical value. So we get 6, and when we add them, we are supposed to get minus 5. So here the two numbers are minus 3 and minus 2, because when you add them, you will get minus 5, and when you multiply them, you will get plus 6. So now replace minus 5a by minus 3a and minus 2a. So we'll get a square minus 3a minus 2a plus 6. So from the first two terms, you can take a as a common term. So when you take a out, we'll get a minus 3. And similarly from the next, if you take minus 2 out, we'll get a minus 3. So now group the terms, we get a minus 3 into a minus 2. Fifth question, factorize a square plus 5a minus 6. So multiply the coefficient of a square and the numerical value, so we get minus 6. And when we add them, we are supposed to get plus 5. So here the values are 6 and minus 1. So when we multiply plus 6 into minus 1, you'll get minus 6. And when you add plus 6 and minus 1, you'll get plus 5. So write, so replace 5a by plus 6a and minus a. So we'll get a square plus 6a minus a minus 6. So from the first two terms, a, take a out, we'll get a plus 6. So from the next two terms, you can take minus 1 outside. So we'll get a plus 6. So we'll get a plus 6 into a minus 1. Sixth question, factorize x square plus 5xy plus 4y square. So even for this question, we'll follow the same procedure. Multiply these two terms, you get plus 4. And when you add them, you're supposed to get plus 5 here. So take the values plus 4 and then plus 1. So when you replace 5xy in terms of 4xy and xy, we get x square plus 4xy plus xy plus 4y square. So from the first two terms, you can take x as common. So we'll get x plus 4y. So similarly, from the next two terms, if you take y as common, again we'll get x plus 4y. So when we group them, we get x plus 4y into x plus y.